The next few videos show how to run several tasks that are frequently used in data analysis. The first one we'll look at is called summarization. As the name implies, summarization adds up numeric values to get a sum or total. The summarization task lets you group the data by one or more fields and calculates subtotals. In the payments database, we will use the summarization task to calculate the total of the amount field for each supplier using the supplier number. The summarization task lets us create a list of unique supplier numbers and calculate the total of their payments. To start, ensure the payments database is active. On the Analysis tab, in the Categorize group, click Summarization. The summarization dialog appears. First, let's select the field to summarize, which determines how to group the data. We want to group the data by supplier using the supplier number, so we'll select SUPNO from the drop-down list. We can select up to 8 fields to summarize. In this example, we are only looking for the payments total for each supplier number, but we could get a lot more granular by adding more fields in the fields to summarize list. If I select Posted By in the second drop-down list, the summarization would produce subtotals for each supplier, further broken down by who posted the payment. For now, we'll keep it simple and only summarize by the SUPNO field, so I will leave the rest of the drop-down lists set to none. In Numeric Fields to Total, check the box for the Amount field. This summarization will calculate the sum of the amount field for each supplier. Even though this task is called summarization, IDEA can calculate other statistics. In Statistics to Include, let's check the boxes for average, minimum, and maximum, in addition to sum, so that IDEA calculates those statistics for each supplier. The output of the summarization task will contain fewer fields than the current database. The Fields button allows you to select any additional fields that you want to carry through to the output, but we will leave that alone for now. Finally, we have to decide what kind of output to produce. Many IDEA tasks allow you to create an IDEA database, a result, or both by checking the corresponding boxes. The database output puts all of the information in an IDEA database, where the information is displayed in a grid. A result is like a miniature report that gets attached to the current database and can be accessed in the Results section of the Properties window over here. Unlike a flat database grid, the way the information is organized in a result is tailored to the particular task. A result often provides more interactivity than a database. In this example, we are going to create a result. Uncheck the box for Create Database and check the box for Create Result. In the result name, enter Summary by Supplier. Now click OK. Let's look at the result. Each supplier number is listed along with the number of records, percentage of records, sum of the amount field, and percentage of the total amount sum for all payments. For supplier 20535, there were 7 payments, which accounts for 3.78% of the number of payments. The sum of those payments totaled roughly $115,000, and that accounts for 5.17% of the total of the amount field for all of the payments. Notice that the values in the number of records field are blue. These are clickable links which provide drill down functionality to let you see all of the records for each customer. To see the 7 records that make up this entry, click the 7 and select Display Records. Click Done to close the preview window. We can view the other statistics we selected using the Statistics drop-down list. Let's select Average. Now I can see the average payment for each supplier. When you're done looking at a result and you want to return to the original database, go to the Properties window and click Data. If you want to return to the result view in the future, simply click Summary by Supplier in the Results section.